A coil gun is nothing more than a metal tube which is able to launch at high speed metal objects using electromagnetic propulsion. Before we get started, if you want to support us, don't forget to leave a like at this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks to this fun experiment, we will better understand the principle of this phenomenon, building what we can call a small version of a magnetic train. For this experiment, we only need a common alkaline battery. In this case, we choose the one with the smaller diameter. 4 cylindrical magnets. JAES, in its catalog, is able to supply a wide range of batteries and a wide range of magnets from different manufacturers. Then we also need a common copper wire, which we are going to roll up on a wooden stick with a diameter of 50 mm. By doing this, we are going to create a copper coil that will represent the tunnel in which our magnetic train will flow. Then we put 2 magnets on the negative pole and other 2 magnets on the positive pole of our battery. In this way, making our small version of a magnetic train. It is better to use cylindrical magnets with a wider diameter compared to the diameter of our battery, to be sure that the magnet's surfaces are in touch with the copper wire when we put the train into the copper coil. Here it goes! Our magnetic train starts to move, shooting straight through the coil in a very short time. That's because the magnets are touching the copper wire on both sides of the battery, allowing electrons flowing through the coil. In fact, when the electricity flows through the copper coil, an electromagnetic field like this one is created. This is responsible for the motion of our magnetic train. Like we already seen in our previous video about the history and the basic principles of electric motors, electric current is a flow of electric charge, which means moving electrons on a wire. In an electric field, the negative electric charges will always feel forced in one direction, while the positive electric charges will always feel forced in the opposite direction. A very similar situation happens in a magnetic field, where a north magnetic pole will be pushed in one direction and a magnetic south pole will be pushed in the other direction. But then why our magnetic train is moving in only one direction when it is immersed in a magnetic field? In our previous video about the history and the basic principle of electric motors, we also explained that inside each magnet there will be always a south and a north pole, and even dividing the magnet into 2 parts, the remaining parts will always have a north and a south pole. So, in this case, if we put a magnet in a uniform magnetic field, it's not gonna move. That's because the thrust towards the north pole and the south pole are equal. But if the magnet is immersed in a non-uniform magnetic field of our copper coil, it will have a bigger push towards the north pole than the south pole. Then, if we place the magnets on the battery facing each other in this way, where the south poles are on the outside while the north poles are in the middle, the north poles will feel a stronger push, which is able to counter the weaker push of the south poles. So, if the train is pushed inside the coil in this way, it will be able to move quickly in this direction. Finally, if you found this video useful, let us know by leaving a comment and subscribing to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on the release of new videos. Thanks for watching.